This is Dr. Shannon Soucy, and this module is Introduction to Bash for Biologists. This module is intended to introduce you to the Bash coding language and familiarize you with the terminal interface. The large size of modern genomic datasets often requires the use of high-performance compute systems, HPCs, that are accessed remotely, often through a terminal interface. Additionally, some bioinformatics software is distributed in the form of a graphical user interface, or GUI. But these GUIs are often clunky, leverage outdated versions of software, and limit the options available for utilizing the software. By building familiarity with the terminal interface, this enables biologists to both increase the compute power available to them by leveraging HPCs, as well as enable them to utilize the full suite of options on the latest versions of bioinformatics software with Bash coding. This module is built from 7 submodules that each build on the skills from a previous submodule. In the end, you will be able to conduct your own analysis with software that you've installed, and you'll learn how to mitigate some common errors. In the first submodule, you will learn to interact with the terminal interface. You'll understand the concept of directory structures and how to navigate them. The second submodule will discuss cloud compute resources, how to access Google Cloud compute resources using a terminal interface. In the third submodule, we'll discuss standardized genomic file formats and interact with those files using the Bash coding language. In the fourth submodule, we will build more complex Bash code using the Bash code that we've learned in the previous submodules, combined into one single complex code. In the fifth submodule, you'll be installing software with the Conda package manager. In the sixth submodule, you'll be analyzing data that you've installed with a Conda package manager and then using Bash commands to leverage those software. You'll perform genome assembly and annotation. In the last submodule, we'll discuss some common error messages and learn how to interpret and respond to those when working on the terminal. The data that you'll use in this module comes from several different sources. You'll use FASTA files that were downloaded from NCBI and that correspond to the Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus 2 Isolate Wuhan WHO 1. The FASTQ files that we use will be downloaded from the SRA archive with this accession number and are part of a surveillance effort for SARS-CoV-2 infections in Western New Hampshire. There's a FASTA file containing ribosomal protein sequences. And lastly, we'll be using FASTQ files in the Google bucket from an RNA-seq dataset described by Himes et al. And these were downloaded from the SRA and subsequently downsampled to streamline the tutorials.